Here we are going to see in this video the construction and working of an internal expanding brake. As the name, here we are having an internal expanding brake. It is also called as drum brake. If we look at the diagram, here the parts of the brake are given. We can see that at first here we are having a brake lining which is red in color. Next, we have the brake drum. This brake drum is the member which will be rotating, and we have to stop the rotation of this member. Then we have a backing plate. Backing plate is like a support. It acts as a support for the internal expanding brake. Next, we have a cam. This cam is the actuating mechanism. It means because of the cam, the braking action takes place. The starting of the braking action is provided with the help of cam. Then we have retractor spring. Now retractor spring is used that once the braking action has been taken place, and then you have to bring the brakes into their proper position, that is the initial position. For that we are using the retractor spring. So this was regarding the construction of internal expanding brake. Next, if we see how it works, at first when we are pressing the brake pedal, means when we are driving a vehicle, and in that if we are pressing the brake pedal, then through linkages, through mechanical linkages, the brake pedal is connected to the cam. The moment we press the brake pedal, this cam will rotate, and when this cam rotates, it will be pressing or it will be pushing the brake shoes, which we can see here, the brake lining, towards the brake drum. It means the brake drum is rotating. Suppose I am assuming the direction as clockwise. Brake drum is rotating in clockwise direction, and here at bottom, if we are seeing these two, they are called as anchor pins. Anchor pins are like fulcrum pins. That is, when the cam rotates, this brake assembly will try to move about this fulcrum. So here when the cam gets actuated, when the cam is moving, then about the fulcrum, these brakes, they would be moving outside. And hence, when they are moving outside, the surface of the brake lining comes in contact with the inner surface of the brake drum, and then the vehicle, or you can say the brake drum, stops. So this was regarding the functioning of internal expanding brake. Instead of cam, we can even have your cylinder and piston arrangement. That is, the brake fluid will enter, it will push the piston on both the sides, and then because of that pistons, the brake lining would be coming in contact with the brake drum. So that is another method of actuating the internal expanding brake. One method is we can use cam here, and the second method is we can use the piston and cylinder arrangement. Now, such kind of brakes, as they are called as drum brake, the advantage of drum brake is that it is enclosed. Means here the construction which we are seeing, this construction will be visible to us once we open the brake drum. Otherwise, it is completely protected. Next, when the brake lining gets worn out, in that case, the braking for such kind of brakes, it is very much, we can say, effective as compared to the other brakes. So that is an advantage of internal expanding brake. And if we consider where it is used, it is mostly used in cars, and we can say that in all four-wheeler vehicles. The disadvantage of this brake is that here the cooling of the brake, because as we know, when braking action takes place, lot of heat is generated. So since internal expanding brake is enclosed, we can say it is very much closed, in that case what happens, that the brake doesn't get cooled effectively. So that is a disadvantage of internal expanding brake, and that is why to overcome that disadvantage, we are going on to disc brake. So with this, we complete internal expanding brake.